A solar power system is comprised of three main components. Technically, there is more, but we will get into that. In today's video, we want to break down the three main components, give you a quick analogy and a demonstration to help you fully understand what those components are, how they function, and how they all work together to create a solar power system. So what is up, you guys? Welcome back to the lab. This is the second video in a very short little series playlist that we're putting together for you guys to help you understand the basics of solar. We want you guys to be able to understand the terms and concepts, as well as be able to appropriately size and choose a system or power station that actually fits your needs. So let's get into it. First main component is a solar panel. Now this obviously is a very tiny solar panel, but the solar panel's job is to capture the energy from the sun and turn it into a usable electricity. In most cases, it's gonna turn it into DC or direct current, which we explained in the last video. And solar panels are measured in watts. So this tiny guy right here, for example, is a 25 watt solar panel. And all solar panels on the back will have some sort of cabling that comes off of the panel and has some fittings on it that you're able to then run to your battery bank or your inverter. And solar panels, even though they all look the same, actually come in a ton of different shapes and sizes. So like I said, this is a 25 watt panel. You can get 100 watt panels, 200 watt panels, 400 watt panels. At the end of the day, they all do the exact same job. And what you're trying to focus on is how many watts you are getting from the total amount of panels that you have. The first and most important component on a solar power system is the solar panel. The second main component of a solar power system is your battery. So this, for example, is a 12 volt, 2,636 watt hour battery. All batteries are also measured in watt hours, and they store the direct current that your solar panels have produced inside of them. Now, you don't technically need batteries for a solar power system. You could be running a system where you're selling the energy back to the utility company, but in our opinion, systems without batteries just don't make sense. Batteries, like solar panels, come in a ton of different shapes and sizes and size ratings. So this is a small little 12 volt, 2,600 watt hour battery. Right here, these are bigger 48 volt, 5,000 watt hour batteries. These fit nicely into a system that they call a server rack, which is just how you stack them all up. These would take up more of a footprint on the floor. There's a ton of different options and sizes and voltages for batteries. But for the most part, you just need to be focused on what the capacity is. And once you find a kit that suits your needs, you can figure out different battery types if you need to. And the final main component for a power system is your inverter. So inverters, again, come in all different shapes and sizes. This is what a more typical solar power inverter is gonna look like. And the inverter actually plays a role twice. We said initially that the solar panels produce DC current that comes down and gets stored in your batteries. Most of the time, that current passes through your inverter, and your inverter will have a built-in charge controller that monitors and makes sure that all the voltages and everything going into the batteries are stable so you don't blow stuff up. But the main point of your inverter is to take that DC power that has been stored in your batteries, take it into the inverter, switch it over to AC, which you can then use to power all of your stuff. And this is responsible for the conversion process. And again, this is more of like a traditional off-grid style one, but there's also things like this that you guys might see on a boat, or you might even have a tiny version of this that plugs into a 12 volt socket in your car and you use it to charge your laptop on a road trip. And again, as you can see clearly, these are measured in watts, like everything else in a solar power system. And the main thing that you need to focus on when you're looking at inverters is the wattage. How much does it output, which will tell you how much stuff you can run off of it. And the solar input is also a key component to that. How much solar power can it actually allow into it and monitor to send to the batteries? And you might also be looking at a unit like this, which is a portable power station. This literally combines the battery and the inverter and makes it super easy and maneuverable to use. These offer a ton of value in different aspects. Like, they have all the ports and plugs and everything already built right into the front of them. Most of them come with some sort of light, which is nice if you're moving around and taking this thing with you. And they almost all come somewhere with a solar power input. So you can still plug a solar panel directly into this. So everything that you're learning also applies to these smaller portable power stations, even the bigger portable power stations. But to make it all make sense, we're gonna break it down into individual components because you can't actually see the inverter or the batteries inside of this thing. And so to give you guys just a quick visual of an actual system, this is just a simple solar power system that we have mounted up to hopefully help you guys understand just a little bit better. And you can see the main components right away. We have our inverter mounted up on the wall. We have our batteries sitting right here. We obviously need to get them inside of a proper rack, and the solar panels are outside. So right here, you guys can see behind the compressor, it's kind of awkward. You can see these cables coming in from outside. These are our solar power cables. They're bringing the wattage from on the roof down into the house. They run through this, which is basically a safety switch, Now the power is running through these into the inverter. Now it's not, so I can touch them and I won't get electrocuted. That runs up into the bottom of the inverter. The inverter processes the information. It has a built-in solar charge controller. Sends the power out through these cables. This is just a glorified version of a bus bar. Sends it into the batteries right here where the power is then stored. All that this is doing is giving us the ability to basically have multiple connections coming off of these batteries without having to have a bunch of different leads bolted onto the battery terminals themselves. It just keeps it a little bit cleaner. You can see right here, these are our AC plugs. They come out from the AC port on the inverter. So this is a 3000 watt inverter and it's spitting out a cable right here that goes down to some plugs. We have access to 3000 watts of power right there. And when we're using those, it's just gonna be pulling power back from these batteries through the cables up into the inverter, converting it to AC, because up until this point, it's been DC power, converting it to AC and then spitting it out down here so we can charge drill batteries. That's all we've been doing so far. And like that, it's very, very simple. This inverter also has the option for AC in. So this is a cord that runs down over to here. And if I plug this guy right here into the wall, you end up putting 120 volts of power from the wall through this cable, through the inverter. It inverts it from AC to DC because now we're putting AC in, and then it sends it over to the batteries for storage. So an analogy that we like to use to make this make sense is literally just your bank account. Your bank account is like your battery bank. Your paycheck is like your solar input, and your spending habits are like your inverter. And so to put numbers to this, say you had $2,000 in your bank account, that's equivalent to your battery bank. And if you have a 1500 watt inverter, or a $1,500 spending habit every 2 weeks, you know that for the next 2 weeks, you're gonna spend about 1500 bucks. You're gonna have 500 left. And that's good news because every 2 weeks, your solar panels produce another $2,000 paycheck right into your bank account and you're good to go. And just like everybody's financial situation being completely different, everybody's solar kit could be completely different. You could have a tiny amount of solar, but you get paid every single day. Or you could have a massive solar array that gives you a huge paycheck, but you live somewhere like we do where you might go 3 weeks in the winter without getting a paycheck at all. So what you need to make sure is that that battery bank or your checking account has enough money in it and your spending habits are good enough that you're always gonna have enough money in your bank to go do whatever you want while you're waiting for that next paycheck to come from your solar panels. And like I said at the beginning, there is just a few extra components that are not necessarily main components, but are worth noting because you're probably gonna see them in other people's videos or in descriptions for kits or products that you're looking at. And the first one is a charge controller. Now this is kind of becoming a little more obsolete as a lot of inverters, like this one on the wall and the MPP one that I already showed you guys, has a charge controller built directly into it. So the solar comes from the panels through the inverter to the batteries. You don't have to worry about it. But what this does here is it takes all of the wonky voltage that's coming out of your solar panels, because as the sun comes in and out behind clouds, your panels are producing more and less voltage. This takes it, smooths it all out, and sends it to your batteries and make sure that there's not going to be any overloading or anything like that. You're not going to blow your battery bank up. And that is his main job. Like I said, most inverters nowadays have a solar charge controller built in, but if not, that is one extra component that you might be seeing. You also might be seeing something like this, which is a distributor, or even a bigger version like this Lynx distributor right here. You may also know this as a bus bar. And what this does is it basically just makes it so that you don't have to have a bunch of connections on your batteries. So what you can do with a bus bar like this is you can run positive wire from your battery to one post, which then, because they're all on the same piece of metal right here, gives power to all of these posts. So you could have your battery coming in, and then you could have from this post going out to your inverter, from this post goes to another inverter, and from this post goes to your charge controller. So they all get power, and it's all very clean and easy to understand, and you could just take one off at a time, something like that. Similarly to how, if you look at this system right here, there's some open spaces because we don't have it completely jammed up, but if we wanted to expand that system, we can do so without having to add a bunch of connections and wires directly to the terminal on the battery. You also might see a PV array isolator, and basically what that is just a switch. We have one right here, and that switch has your solar coming in from the roof, and then it runs over to your inverter. And that switch basically just disconnects those wires, which makes it safe to work on your system. So if I was actually gonna do any kind of servicing or rewiring of this inverter behind me, I would just kill the switch, which disconnects the power. And now any live power that's coming from the panels on my roof, which are producing voltage in the sun, isn't going to the rest of the wiring, and it's safe for me to touch it and change it and do all that kind of stuff. And so that is it. That is the fundamentals and the main components of a solar power system and how all the components work together. I hope this video made sense, and I hope it helped some of you guys. If it did, make sure you share it with some friends and help some more people understand some technology that can actually help to better all of our lives. Otherwise, I will catch you guys in the next one. Thank you guys so much for watching. Peace out and stay charged.